In sports, the Ateneo Blue Eagles' road to the UAAP Season 85 championship was not easy. ABS-CBN Sports content lead Mix Bustos sat down with head coach Tab Baldwin to talk about the team's toughest title run yet. Here's an excerpt of that interview.
Kindly describe your run. If you would get to summarize that in a couple of points, your run in Season 85.
I mean, obviously, if you're on the outside looking in, you see that, it was a bit patchy in the first round, our performances. We had some losses, big loss to LaSalle, and then lost to UP. And then we got into the second round. And, you know, obviously after, you know, more games under our belt, we're starting to play better. But NU game was really tough. And, they proved their worth in this season and how strong they were, and they gave us a pretty good touch up in that game. It set us up for kind of having the right mentality coming into the UP game in the second round, and getting that win was a big boost for the team, big boost for our confidence, just knowing that, you know, the defending champions, which are a very good team, but, you know, they'd had their ups and downs during the season as well. And then, you know, we didn't look great against FEU, but we kind of, you know, finished the season pretty strong with our game against Adamson. And then, of course, the semifinal against Adamson, and we had maybe our best game of the season. Coming into the finals, we knew it would be really tough. And I had a lot of players that were new to the finals, and they were anxious, nervous. And I think the first game, UP had a great start. Of course, you know, a great game two, and that really set up a game three, which was always going to be a battle royale, if you will. And I think that we had a great start in that game, and then we just held on. We already knew that Goldwin and his coaching staff are good at making adjustments. They're good at changing things up. But a lot of that is, you know, just on the surface. Like, when you play a season as a basketball team, you develop a character. So for us, it was really about anticipating that there might be some cosmetic changes to what UP was doing, and there were. But those are really more, and we were doing the same thing. And those are really to sort of disguise as much as you can what the true essence of your performance is going to be. But at the end of the day, we all come back to the norm after you've played a full season. You know, we just had to be ready to beat UP at their best. And of course, the loss of Xavier means they couldn't be at their very best. And they had to make some adjustments to that. And because that really thinned out their front line, we could, to a degree, anticipate sort of the combinations they were going to have to go with because they were fewer. And that helped us. You know, I'm not going to be one of those guys that say, oh, well, with or without Lucero, it would be the same game. I don't think so. You know, that was really bad fortune for them and good fortune for us. But that's sport, you know, and that's what Zave said to me after the game. He said, look, this is sport. This is what happens.
A stark admission from TikTok parent company ByteDance. The Chinese tech giant reveals some of its employees improperly accessed the TikTok user data of two journalists from the Financial Times and BuzzFeed. This as they investigated potential employee leaks to the press. The ByteDance staffers looked at the IP addresses of the journalists to see if they were in the same location as the employees suspected of leaking confidential information. The admission comes after the company intensified a campaign to reassure customers and governments users' data privacy is protected and that it poses no threat to national security.